Fur seals are attacking beachgoers, surfers, and divers in Cape Town, South Africa. These attacks convinced authorities to test a number of seals for rabies. 75% of the tests came back positive in what has become the first known major outbreak of rabies in marine mammals. I'm KP, a marine biologist who specializes in marine mammals. And to learn more about this unique situation, I sat down with Ocean Conservation Namibia's Naude Dreyer.
Awesome, how are you going?
Good, and you?
Yeah, I'm good. Fans of my channel know you guys super well. There's a lot of crossover there. But maybe for those that don't know, maybe you just give a quick little intro of who you are and what you guys do.
I'm Nadia from Ocean Conservation Namibia, one of the co-founders. We are based in Namibia, and our mission at the moment is to catch as many seals and release them from entanglements. We have a big issue with animals, marine animals, mainly seals, Cape fur seals in our area, getting stuck in fishing lines, nets, and things like that. And we go out, we've got specialized equipment, pretty much self-taught, but some specialized equipment to catch these animals and cut them free. To date, we've caught and released nearly 4,000 Cape fur seals.
As you can probably tell, I am a huge fan of Ocean Conservation Namibia, and I'm guessing you probably are too. If you're interested in supporting their heroic efforts to free entangled fur seals, just head over to their website, ocnamibia.org. I've made it easy for you by putting links in the descriptions, pinned comment, and I've put a link to their YouTube channel right up here.
Wild, especially in the marine mammal world, you guys are experiencing, or I should say your neighbors to the south are experiencing, an outbreak in rabies. Which is the first ever documented in any marine mammal, as far as I know. And so you just went to, it was a conference or something like that. Can you tell us a bit more about what you learned there?
Yeah, so this was actually, we've been dealing with, in South Africa, there's been a spate of attacks of seals on humans. Surfers, divers, snorkelers, particularly. So there's been a lot of things thrown around, and one of the big sort of hypotheses was domoic acid poisoning. Mm. And there's been a lot, we spent a lot of time collecting samples, the South African, to prove, because domoic acid can affect in quite a neuro way.
Domoic acid is a harmful neurotoxin produced by algal blooms known as red tide. It kills hundreds of marine mammals every year in the U.S. alone.
Officials sounding the alarm after hundreds of sea lions were poisoned by a toxic algae bloom.
Domoic acid attacks the heart and the brain, causing heart failure and permanent brain damage. Symptoms include seizures, vomiting, and aggression.
The sea lion disappeared underwater, and then it was biting him.
It bit me on my knee.
Which are some of the same symptoms of rabies, so it's easy to see how the two could be confused.
We're seeing a lot of the animals having seizures and things, so that was the main theory. And nobody really thought to test for rabies, for doing all these tests all along, because seals shouldn't get rabies. Then what happened was a dog tested positive after being bitten by a seal. So basically one thing led to another. The seal was tested positive for rabies, and they thought, okay, wow. So they tested a lot of these older samples, those that have been suspected of domoic acid, and were getting seizures and things. So the suspected seals were tested, and suddenly there were four tests and then positives. Right now they're up to 18 positive tests.
Currently there is no sufficient way to test for rabies antemortem, which means before death. The only effective way to test for rabies is a direct fluorescent antibody test of an animal's brain, specifically the entire section of the cerebellum, hippocampus, and the brainstem.
Yeah, this has just suddenly sprung up on everybody. So what 6 months ago was planned as a seal behavior conference turned into basically a rabies conference. Let's get anybody who knows anything about rabies, knows anything about seals and seal behavior, let's get together and sort of figure out. One of your ferrets are running around.
Oh, it's there. I live with feral creatures.
Yeah. Yeah. So, yeah, this conference came together basically just to figure out, okay, what's happening, what is the extent, and what do we do about what are the protocols going to be, how are we going to move forward with this whole thing?
Yeah, so that like just brings up a lot of other questions, I guess, in my mind. So, because we have domoic acid here off the coast of California with the California sea lion, so do we think that the rabies had been around maybe for a little while and it just wasn't being tested for? Because like you said, which is not really like something that you might do if you are like, it's just domoic acid poisoning.
Okay, so yeah, that is definitely, it's definitely suspected that it's been around for a long time. And a lot of, they're testing, they sort of backdated samples, I think as far back as 2021 that have been tested that have, or 2022 that have so far that have been tested that have been tested positive for rabies. So it's been around for a while.
Wow. That's interesting. That makes me wonder if it's here, if it's everywhere.
That's the big question, and that's the big fear now. Maybe we've been living it with this whole time and we didn't even know, and it's something we shouldn't worry about at all. Is it a new thing that's just gonna take over like wildfire? There's so many questions because it's such a new phenomenon.
There's so many unknowables here, but is there any kind of like theory as to how they might have gotten it in the first place?
You've got smaller colonies of seal, or actually pretty big colonies of seals, higher up the west coast of South Africa. Very remote areas. And there are quite a lot of jackal and hyena in this, brown hyena in this area. And it's most, the theory is that it's most likely come from jackals, because jackals are carriers of rabies in Namibia as well. It could very well have come from Namibia too and then moved south.
Okay, and so are you guys doing any testing in Namibia, or is this strictly happening in South Africa right now?
No, well, I've been speaking to the state vets, the Ministry of Fisheries, and so far we have not found any suspicious cases or suspicious enough cases here to test for. The key sign is aggression, like sort of unwarranted aggression, but there's also a lot of other factors that could contribute to that.
So people have been bitten and kind of
lots.
Lots. Okay. Is this a case of people are approaching these animals, or are these animals like really unprovoked attacking people?
Yeah, that's exactly it. Unprovoked attacking people. I mean, people have been working around seals. There's one of the most amazing companies, the Seal Snorkeling in Cape Town, that has been operating for years and years, snorkeling with around a seal colony, and suddenly they've had 13 attacks on their snorkelers. They've had to close down now, where seals, they've always got their curiosity, especially the pups when you're in the water. And on land, say 99% of the time, if you come close to a seal, it's going to run away from you, or our seals at least. I know some other species don't, but these seals are generally scared of people. So these cases are just basically walking past, and these seals just coming out of the water with surfers. It's not just a coordinated bite and go. That you can see these animals are, there's serious neuro issues there. These animals are just sort of completely erratically just biting and going crazy. I'll send you a video of one case.
A
video of the seal. It didn't bite anyone, but this one was just sort of behaving very erratically. It had, and they did catch it. They euthanized it, and it did test positive, just to show the sort of abnormal behavior.
Yeah, I wanna see that video.
Quickly sending you that video.
Oh yeah.
That video is all around. It's public.
Oh yeah. Okay. Wow.
Oh, run!
Yeah, I mean that's obviously
that's really erratic behavior from a seal. Yeah.
Yeah, and this person's not in any way bothering them and is like completely out of reach, so to be going so aggressively at that is like, that's really interesting stuff. So
the good news is that rabies is an easily treatable disease. So if you've ever been bit by an animal, it's best to go see a doctor and ask if you need to be treated. There are also rabies vaccines, which I strongly recommend for your pets or yourself if you're at risk.
And so you mentioned you guys got vaccinated, so that's awesome. And is it affecting your work in any other way?
We're just basically keeping a more vigilant eye out for anything suspicious. So we're definitely trying a little harder to not get bitten. I think we would notice that we'd pick up that behavior change very quickly. The seal's always very consistent, running away from us. If we're in their way, they'll bark. But they'll still not run at us, and it's a much more erratic, like snapping, and that displays with the rabies. Okay. So I think we would be aware of that a lot quicker. Also, you've got to look back to, it's not a, I don't think, it's a question I kept asking there, it's not a threat to the population, it's not a rapidly spreading, massively infectious disease. You've got a, so the R-naught factor of what do they say, one or something, or one infected animal would be most likely to infect one more. And it's not going to wipe out the entire population. Most of our seal colonies are actually not near people. You don't have it in like in South Africa, where you've got groups of seals in the harbors, where you've got lots of tourists coming around. We do have in Namibia basically one colony that is a popular tourist attraction. I mean, we're doing kayaking tours there. We've got boat tours going past there, which could be a problem. But so far there's been no suspicious, nothing, no big problems yet.
So I've obviously edited the video for time, and I cut some of our casual conversation. But if you want to see the entire interview, let me know in the comments below. And maybe like and subscribe if you're enjoying the content.
Awesome. Well, thanks for sitting down. Stay safe out there. I hope nobody gets bit.
Yeah.
I'm always so nervous for you guys, and whenever I see, oh, you know, somebody got bit, I'm like, rinse it out, wash it really well.
we've got such a good like first aid protocol now. Like we're pretty good about that.
Awesome.
And yeah, good, enjoy your orca.
Yeah, I'm gonna go try and find them. So okay, well, thanks, Naude.
Cool. Thanks so much.
Bye.